Hi, and welcome back to another episode of My Rawgasms and the Raw Essentials program. And I'm now cutting up some ginger, and I've got David from Canadian Way, the best salmon in the world, the sockeye, that he imports all the way from Canada. He is a Canadian, by the way, so he knows his salmon, and he gets it before the bears do. And of course, we've got Jason Woodford, local member for Parliament here in Nudgee in Brisbane, and he's the guy that's extremely outspoken on getting healthy eating into the schools. And let me tell you a little bit about that.
Please do.
I think it's the best thing that a politician has ever done.
Thank you. Well, I think it's stuff for their kids.
Most of them just talk about it, but you're actually doing anything. Yep. And when we, did I say anything? Everything. The thing is, we have tried everything else. The healthcare system is what it is. It's not actually healthcare, it's a disease kind of management system.
Yes.
So as a disease management system, it's also failed. Because the rates are going up.
Yes.
So what we need to do is take responsibility ourselves. And that's a bit what this whole Raw Essentials program and that is all about. Eating better, getting the preservatives, the additives, the chemicals, the numbers that affect the nervous system and all that sort of thing. So have a Google at this guy here and grab that guy's salmon. Now, what we're doing today, anyway, you guys have a little chat and then I'll, amongst yourselves, no?
Okay, we can chat about it.
Okay, yeah. All right, well what we're doing here, we've got, on another episode we did what?
No, she's talking. Danger, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. All right, come on guys, say something. They're waiting for someone else to talk with me.
I was a quiet child, I didn't really do much.
Yeah.
But no. The thing is also with the let's go back to the kids and also their health, the disease management system, is that
waiting for the disease to happen, they're trying to manage it.
Yeah,
why not prevent it?
Exactly. And I read this book.
Are they waiting for it to happen, or are
they creating it? They're actually
promoting
it. Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, it's. Yeah.
Let's be blunt.
We're amongst friends.
We don't have to be politically correct.
Yeah, we're amongst friends. But you know, I read this book once that said. The outcome of the whole sickness and health industry was that we needed better doctors and nurses.
Yeah.
That would fix the system.
Yeah, yeah, that was a good one.
But if we're still putting crap in our mouth, how is it going to fix the problem?
I must give you this book. You don't understand.
It's like we need better paint to last longer to cover up the patches.
That's it.
You know,
that's it.
And instead of that's it. So it's like, look, I'm a bit gobsmacked sometimes when I hear that sort of thing's going on, but I'm probably a little bit more gobsmacked at the fact of, and I'm not really bagging you out, but I am, in that it's up to us to take action and do some Googling and find out the facts. Because if you're ignorant to the facts, I'm not saying you're ignorant, but a lot of people are, you need to find out. When you find out, you go, well, it really gets to what I put in my body, and then you've got to change, and that's when it becomes hard, because you can't find good food out there. I mean, it's so quick to go through a drive-thru. Or you could just run through a fruit and vegetable store.
Yes.
Grab some apples, grab some nuts and seeds and dried fruits and, you know, all that sort of thing, whip something together.
But you got to park your car.
Oh, yeah. So that there's the solution to the problem. Drive through fruit and veggie stores.
Drive through drugstores. Remember, we call them drugstores.
That's right.
Drive through. I'll have a couple of those bananas and a few cherries and don't forget the cucumber on the way through.
How about a drive through smoothie bar?
Oh, yeah.
Bring it on. Yeah. Bring it on.
Well, you can pick your fruit and vegetables. Hey, we're giving someone an idea. Some entrepreneurs out there going, hey, now call those folks. We can do that. All right, I'm going to tell you what we're doing. We've got the standard. This is the favorite of all everything. This is the cashew cream. So all it is cashew nuts soaked overnight, blended in their own water. Little bit of vanilla extract or vanilla bean or whatever you want to do. I'm just going to put a little bit in there. And a little bit of mixed spice. This is I'm terrible at measuring anything. Just all goes in there with me. And the secret ingredient that we're doing today, because we've done this before. This is, did I grab the right one? Is that the one I should have?
Sure.
Okay. This is maple syrup. This is Joe's wine maple syrup. Now tell us about the maple
syrup. What?
Joe wine? Oh, ice wine! It looked like a Joe. I thought, where did the Joe come from?
Yeah, it's pure maple syrup, 100% maple syrup, but they do infuse it with less than 1% ice wine. Ice wine are frozen grapes.
It does look like Joe, doesn't it?
It does. A quick glance.
Yeah, basically they freeze the grapes at one part of the season. At the end of the season, they leave a few grapes left over and they freeze them. They let them freeze in the winter time, and then they pick them frozen and process them frozen. That's ice wine. So this has less than 1% ice wine. It just gives it that little sort of schnapps taste, I call it, because I remember when I was
a kid,
it's
what it is. Yeah.
But it's a nice sweet, but it's still pure maple syrup. So you can use it to put on your fresh fruits or your ice cream or anything you want, pancakes if you like. It just has that little spark. Yeah, I mean,
organic pancakes.
Organic pancakes. Yeah. Non-breaded pancakes. But anyway, so that's what we're using today.
Like banana cakes.
It's like the regular maple syrup, but it just has that little. This is the regular maple syrup here.
So. Okay, and that is just the cutest little bottle. Looks like a perfume bottle.
So these are like you know, little gift type. You don't want to just buy these all the time and pour them because they're a little more expensive. So best to get the just standard bottles and use these for gifts. So this is maple syrup.
And what a great gift. You give someone a gift of really good quality food as opposed to flowers. Not that I'm bagging out the flower people, but you can't eat one. You can eat them. Okay, so I'm just going to wash my hands.
Please do.
You're going to love this. This is one of those desserts. It's Jason's favourite. When you get cashews, you can do any sort of cream with them. It's a matter of what you mix with them, of course. So right now, what I've put in, just to reiterate, is David from Canadian Way. He's got the Jakemans, which is, it does look like Joe on there, but it's ice wine, the maple syrup. Absolutely beautiful.
Yeah.
Vanilla essence, a mixed spice, and the cashews. Now, I've thrown a bit of uncrystallized ginger in there because we've done it other ways before. So this one I'm going to do just a little bit differently. Oh, you guys want individual bowls, don't you? Mm-hmm. I know you're going to want to just have a taste. So this is, it's almost like a Romanoff type thing. It's got your strawberry and your ginger in there. And I've got a little treat for them too, as well as doing it this way. So let's do that. Now, this is a secret ingredient that we have here. This is actually, it's the maple sugar. So again, we're going to sprinkle a little bit on the top, Jason, because you haven't had this way before.
No,
little bit of mixed nutmeg on the top there.
I can hear him
drooling there. Okay, you can wrap your laughing gear around that and tell us what you think of that.
No, that's heaven.
And it's cashew nuts. You know, we haven't got any dairy in there or anything like that. Mm. And we'll put, isn't the maple sugar just amazing?
Whoa.
And how simple was that as a dessert?
Thank you.
Your laughing gear around that one. So the maple syrup, so this is a great range. And of course, you know, this is a little bit different. Actually, you can tell us, you've told us a little bit about this.
Mm-hmm.
But this is what part of the plant?
No, okay. Oops. So maple syrup, what happens is it's sap that comes out of the tree and it gets processed to evaporate the water and then it turns into a syrup. Once it's a syrup, there's no other process that's done. It's strictly straight from the tree. The sap is a clear, watery substance. It's got the maple in it, which is what it is, maple sap. It goes into the processor, evaporates as much of the water out to form the syrup, and you have different levels of evaporation to have the thickness. The maple sugar basically is the syrup, and they've actually dehydrated it a bit, not in dehydrator, but they've moved it in a certain way, they've mixed it, they've rotated it, and it just dries up a bit and crystallizes, and that's when it becomes the sugar. So it comes in little particles or little chunks. So that's still 100% pure. So 100%, the maple syrup is always 100% pure. Maple sugar is 100% pure maple syrup that's been, you know, dried out, and they have the maple spread, which is basically what you put on your bread and that kind of stuff. And that's just the same thing, just a different process of movement to dry it out in a certain way, and they whip it up more. Rather than just slowly move this, and they whip this up much more. And that's the difference.
And meanwhile, I ran around the corner there because on my Easy Dry dehydrator, I put, using this sort of whole theory, I've got maple syrup, maple sugar, mashed banana, and a little bit of coconut. Now these could be a 2 day dry. They've just been overnight, but you're going to get the idea. So imagine this as, they're still hot. Imagine that as a little wrap with that in the middle. We'll show this on another show.
Imagine that just on its own.
Isn't that nice?
Oh. they'd like to try your piece just in case.
Okay. So what do you think of those? God. Doesn't the maple flavour?
No, I'll put some.
Why do you need anything else with that?
Mm? Oh, that's what I mean. How good's that?
It's on.
With the ginger and the coconut. It's absolutely amazing. So because these are more on the soft side, you could make them into a wrap and put that in, isn't it?
Can I try that piece
now? Yeah, have a look. Go, knock yourself out. We'll come back to a recipe on these. So we haven't really got I haven't got a name for these guys. Just haven't got a name for them because I just made them up last night because David's been staying over and looking at, you know, his ingredients and what we could do. So doing a maple banana ginger biscuit.
So again, what's in that?
All I did was mash a banana, put some uncrystallized ginger in it, a little bit of coconut and your maple sugar and a little bit of maple syrup.
Okay, I've got to watch this episode again. Just amazing, amazing.
I can taste that now too.
Yeah, with the ginger. So how does it go with, can I pinch a little bit of this one? How's that one?
It really is.
It's good because that sort of overpowers it in one way because it's so yum. So you're not missing out. Like that's yum on its own.
Yeah, you're not losing it. That's right. You're not losing the both tastes. They're both their own taste.
Let's
try
some of that at the same time.
Yeah, well, this is something you'd be great to give the kids as a breakfast. Because really what you've got in here is I can't think of a breakfast cereal that could be anywhere close to having the nutritional value of what we've got here.
I'm just going to have a little bit more. Oh, my goodness.
So with the maple syrup in terms of it's a natural sugar. So it's a syrup, right? But it has a natural sugar. So it burns in your body naturally. Like when they say don't have too much sugar, that's because you have refined sugar. It sits in it. It goes in the wrong cavities of your body. Whereas the maple syrup goes down the right way, goes out the right way, and it doesn't affect your body in any negative way at all. Actually benefits because all the antioxidants it has, and manganese, and there's so many different nutritional...
Well, it hasn't got the nutrition out of it.
No.
Real food, unprocessed, has it all there. The body knows. The body knows what to do with it.
Oh, well, I forgot to put the mango in it.
Yeah. Oh, don't worry.
You could have probably forgot to put a few things that didn't matter.
Yeah.
I mean, it's that good as it is.
Oh, yeah. Amazing.
Mm.
That is really nice.
All right. Well, that's the end of... What do we start off with? So we've got your cashew maple cream with strawberries and ginger in it. You can leave ginger out. I was going to put mango in it, but
that beats
Jason
porridge
said,
anyway.
It'll just, anyway, we get it. And then, of course, this biscuit, which we'll show you on another. It's more of a wrap now, but if I leave them 2 days, they'll be crunchy.
Yeah.
And again, kids come in after school. If you don't like the ginger, leave it out. Give them that.
You know what I say?
Better than 2 minute noodles.
Give it to them for the school so they don't go to the tuck shop and get those terrible yummy drummies in.
Get yourself a DI. What's a yummy drummy?
It's a name for a processed chicken. Oh. Chicken leg that they pretend
well, how about
chicken,
we, yeah,
which isn't chicken leg.
I'm just messing with you. How about it's we terrible. Call this an oh my god banana maple
OMG.
Biscuit?
Yeah,
OMG.
Delicious.
Oh yes.
OMG BB.
Anyway, M-M-B, you've just got to taste it. This food is absolutely amazing. Nice. Thank you for coming in for another episode with all your products. We'll be back with him on another episode as well. And, of course, with Jason. And I can't wait to be working with the schools and actually showing the kids and the parents how to do it. We've got a whole lot of guest chefs coming in, so I have a whole lot of ideas from them as well. So bye from me.
Bye from me.
Bye from me.